Next on PIJN News, Dr. Chaps reports on these important issues.
Congress's Pentagon budget bans military-funded transgender surgeries and abortions. A congressman stumps an Air Force general on transgender questions, but the Air Force Academy is promoting critical race theory.
Former Navy chaplain Gordon James Klingenschmitt took a stand to defend religious freedom by daring to pray publicly in Jesus' name. Now he helps you by reporting the news, discerning the spirits, and praying the scriptures. Would you pray with us? Here's Dr. Chaps.
God bless you in Jesus' name. My name is Chaplain Gordon James Klingenschmitt, Dr. Chaps, and you're watching PIJN News. On this show, we like to do three things. We report the news, we discern the spirits, and we pray the scriptures in Jesus' name. Are you ready to pray the news with us? Here's our first story. The U.S. House of Representatives has passed a version of the NDAA, National Defense Authorization Act, or the Pentagon budget, which actually bans diverting military funds into transgender surgeries and abortions. It has yet to pass the Senate. Epoch Times reports, the House last Friday passed a sweeping annual defense bill that includes a GOP-led group of amendments to restrict abortion coverage and transgender procedures that are being funded with military dollars. They're also trying to eliminate a diversity or affirmative action initiatives at the Pentagon. Most Democrats voted against the measure. Called for the NDAA fiscal year 2024, as did four Republicans, voted against the bill. But it was passed narrowly on a bipartisan vote of 219 to 210. The measure was approved by the House Armed Services Committee in a nearly unanimous vote just weeks ago, but it drew controversy among liberal-minded lawmakers when Republicans added common-sense provisions restricting the diversion of money from the Pentagon to pay for abortion care and sex changes. Representative Lauren Boebert, Republican of Colorado, said at a press conference ahead of the Friday vote the following, quote, "We are continuing to block the Biden administration's woke agenda," end quote. Well, the final version of the bill added Boebert's amendments and several others, which bolster Americans' nuclear deterrent and missile defense. It also includes a wide range of culture war issues, such as repealing DOD's abortion travel policy, which reimburses expenses for service members and DOD employees who want to travel to get an abortion from a state where it's restricted, like a red state, into a state where it's allowed, like a blue state. Government's going to pay for that, maybe even give you bonus pay if you abort your child. But the Republican-led amendments would prohibit that. Also prohibit Pentagon healthcare programs from providing sex reassignment surgeries and gender hormone treatments for transgender individuals, and from providing gender transition procedures through a program designed for special needs family members. So now your transgender spouse, if you have one, can also use the government dime for crazy surgeries. Thanks, Democrats. But no, Republicans are blocking this. Republicans also introduced various changes to diversity, equity, and inclusion programs, so-called DEI affirmative action programs at the Pentagon, which actually promote racism. Republicans want to block those and get rid of racism at the Pentagon, including a measure that bars the DOD's educational arm from buying books containing pornography or books that espouse radical gender ideology. I don't think our taxpayer dollars should be buying those kind of books for sailors. I was a Navy chaplain. Sailors got enough of that material, they can pay for it themselves. The changes also prohibit DOD schools from teaching that the United States or its founders were racist. Passage of the bill in the House sets up now a showdown in the Democrat-led Senate, with many pundits predicting an uphill battle. Democrats widely denounced the bill, accusing Republicans of hijacking what's a normally bipartisan defense spending bill into a culture war issue. That's the news. Our thanks to Epoch Times for that report. You know, I've watched with interest as a 20-year member of the services, as a former Navy chaplain. When the House passes one version of the NDAA, Republican, and the Senate, led by Democrats, passes a different version of the NDAA, you have two versions of the same bill. But then they have to go into what's called conference committee, where you'll get a handful of congressmen, a handful of senators, and they meet in private to haggle on the final version of the bill. And my prediction is, sadly, a lot of these good amendments are going to be pulled out because the Senate won't pass them and Joe Biden wouldn't sign them. But it is good to see the fight. It is good to see conservative Republicans like Lauren Boebert and others fighting for common sense in the Pentagon budget. Let's pray that they have success. The Bible says this in Isaiah 60. Violence shall no longer be heard in your land, neither wasting nor destruction within your borders, but you shall call your walls salvation and your gates praise. Let's pray for the Pentagon as they don't waste this money, right? Father in heaven, we pray in Jesus' name for no more wasting, even at our borders, even at our troops. God, let the money go to equip the troops. That's what we paid for. Give us a strong national defense without all this woke BS that is just going to distract and hurt our military. Father, give them victory over these bad policies. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, let's take a short break. When we come back, a congressman stumps an Air Force general on demigender and agender questions. I don't even know what those are.
Do you have Muslim friends or neighbors living in America? We want to give them Bibles in their native language, and you can help. We're making a free offer to you, the viewing audience, to help give away free Bibles to Muslims. If you want us to send a copy of the New Testament for yourself or a friend in any of the following languages, we would love to send it to you free of charge. We've got an Arabic New Testament available, Farsi New Testament, Turkish New Testament, the Kurdish New Testament in Kurmanji, the Kurdish New Testament Sorani, and the Dari Gospel of John. All you need to do is contact our office by phone, 719-574-5900. Again, that's 719-574-5900, or send an email request to hope@vopg.org. Again, that's hope, H-O-P-E, at vopg.org, and we'll process your request right away. God bless you.
I'm Dr. Chaps. You know, Jesus taught the parable about sowing the seed, and you don't want it wasted. You want it to grow with 30, 60, 100-fold for the kingdom of Jesus Christ. I'll tell you three mission areas that we're doing here at Pray in Jesus' Name. I think our charity does more with less than any other charity I know. We are fertile seed. For example, number one, we pray in millions of television homes every day or every weekend on 8 networks. We have 2.5 billion home TV impressions every month. The second area, we feed orphans and children in some of the poorest slums overseas. We're building a new vocational school, we're digging wells, and we're serving the poor when you give to Pray in Jesus' Name. Number three, we defend religious freedom, especially for our troops and our chaplains. We've now helped send 5 million petitions to Congress. We've helped change bad laws or policies in 13 states and 4 times in federal law. You know my story as a former Navy chaplain, standing up for the right to pray in Jesus' name and defending religious freedom. Would you donate today? In fact, we want you to come up monthly pledge sponsor. When you visit PrayInJesusName.org, on the right side, click the monthly pledge sponsor button at PrayInJesusName.org. Your monthly gift will help change the world in Jesus' name.
He is the intersection of church and state. Here is Dr. Chaps.
Welcome back. I'm Dr. Chaps. We're going to show you a video now of a U.S. congressman in the House Armed Services Committee, Matt Gaetz, is grilling a 3-star general, Lieutenant General Richard Clark of the Air Force Academy, who, to be honest, I'm a graduate of the Air Force Academy, and it disappoints me deeply to see General Clark's failed leadership when it comes to religious freedom for our cadets. But now he's involved in promoting scholarships for cadets who are demigender and agender. What does that even mean? Well, Congressman Gates had some questions.
A diverse and inclusive force is a war-fighting imperative. This is on a slide at the Air Force Academy. General Clark, do you agree with that statement?
I do agree with that statement, sir.
So, I mean, were the Mongols diverse?
Well, sir, I'm not really as versed on Mongol warfighting as
how about the
U.S.
Vikings?
Warfighting.
Were the Vikings diverse?
Again, sir, I'm looking at our country, the most diverse country in the world.
Sure, but this is about a warfighting imperative. How about the force in Ukraine? Are the Ukrainians fighting the Russians a diverse force?
Sir, once again, my concern is the people that I'm charged to build into leaders.
But you would acknowledge that throughout history, including present history, that statement hasn't borne true in every example, right?
Sir, what I would say is that those countries have to rely on the full force of their population to build a war-fighting force to win our wars, and that's why it's important for us to be diverse, because our nation...
So let's look at the population that actually makes up the fighting force frequently. Now, we have more men than women, right? 70-30-ish?
That's right. Correct.
And of the men we have, most of them are not transgender men. Most of them are cisgender men, right?
Yes, sir.
But yet, at our academies, we push something called the Brooke Owens Fellowship. Are you familiar with that?
I am, yes, sir.
And in that fellowship, it specifically says, if you are a cisgender man, this program isn't for you. So you just said that your answer on why we do such this full hug of these diversity concepts is because it's all about the fighting force that we draw from. But you're literally pushing a program in the academies that says, if you're a cisgender woman, a transgender woman, a non-binary, agender, bigender, two-spirit, demigender, what's demigender?
Sir, that's a term of the people that are eligible for that particular scholarship
is
available.
What's a demigender person?
It's a person who looks at their gender in a different way than I do, sir.
Well, sure, that's all of these people. You're a cisgender man. You don't even get to apply.
Well.
Do you know what demigender really means?
I'm not really sure, sir.
Right. So do you know what agender means? All one word, not a space gender, but agender.
Sir, I don't.
Right. So here we are pushing a fellowship, calling for people that you don't even know what the words mean, and the number one group of people, the cisgender men, are excluded. Now, in the name of diversity, equity, and inclusion, should we be pushing programs that we can't define that exclude the largest group of service members?
Well, sir, first, that program is not an Air Force Academy program. It's a program open to our entire country.
Right, so but we you guys advocate for it within the academy.
We allow our cadets to apply for it.
Why are you allowing your cadets to apply for a program when you cannot define the basic terms of eligibility?
Because it's an opportunity for us to develop them as warfighters, and we look for every opportunity that we can.
But you don't even know what the words mean. How can you use this as a way to develop the warfighters if you don't know what it means?
Well, some of those terms may not be applicable to us at the Air Force Academy, but some are.
But if you don't know what they mean, it's hard to tell if they're applicable or not. So I think one of the reasons why some of this stuff has gotten into the academies is because we don't have the same oversight from the Board of Visitors. And, Mr. Chairman, I seek unanimous consent to enter into the record an article from the Washington Examiner entitled, "To Push Woke Ideology, Biden Illegally Gutted Military Academy Oversight Boards." And so in this piece, it goes through a timeline where on September 8th, 2021, all of President Trump's appointees were fired. On September 17th, Secretary Austin created Board of Visitors subcommittees, and then he populated those subcommittees with people who weren't on the Board of Visitors. Have you ever seen that happen before?
Sir, our Board of Visitors is populated and supports us in great fashion.
Right. So. What about the subcommittee? Are there people on the Board of Visitors subcommittees who are not on the Board of Visitors?
I can't answer that, sir.
Seems like something we ought to know.
I'm not sure.
Right, but that would be odd, right? I mean, let me ask the question this way. You don't have any basis to disagree with the reporting here in the Washington Examiner that literally we have people who are not on the Board of Visitors who are serving on these subcommittees. You have no basis to disagree with that, do you?
Sir, I'm not exactly sure the question you're asking. So I'll have to take that for record so I can understand what you're asking.
Thank you, Mr.
Representative Escobar.
I'd like to thank our panel for your service to our nation.
So there you saw it, three-star General Richard Clark. Sir, if you are going to promote scholarships that are, you're disqualified if you're a white male. They just said that, right? But if you're demigender or agender, you get more scholarships. Why, General, are you promoting that nonsense? Again, we call for your resignation. If you are anti-Christ and you don't keep your promises, especially defending religious freedom for your cadets. Let's take a short break. When we come back, the Air Force Academy is also promoting critical race theory.
Hello, I'm Mike Lindell, and I'm here to tell you about my new product from MyPillow, towels that actually work. Watch this absorbency test. Here's another towel that we randomly went out and bought. Here's one of my towels with a nice design. I don't know if you can see this, but you could line a swimming pool with this. I mean, this is crazy. Get rid of it. Towels that actually work. What a concept.
I really love the towels. They're really great. They're super absorbent.
I'm interrupting this commercial to let you know we're having the biggest clearance sale ever. Get our six-piece towel sets for only $29.88 with your promo code. My towel sets are made with proprietary technology and include two bath towels, two hand towels, and two washcloths. So go to MyPillow.com or call the number on your screen. Use your promo code to get our six-piece towel sets. Originally $99.98, then on sale for $49.98. Now we're closing them out for only $29.88 while supplies last. Once they're gone, they're gone. So please order now. You're still looking good.
I'm still feeling good. You know, I've got all your MyPillow products. Mattress topper, bed sheets, MyPillows, towels, slippers, blankets, sleepwear, dog.
Whoa, Charles. Everyone now can get MyPillow products at huge discounts at MyPillow.com. That's right. Now's the time to go to MyPillow.com or call the number on your screen. Use your promo code to take advantage of our 3-in-1 sale. We're bringing you exciting new products, overstock specials, and closeout deals you won't find anywhere else. For example, when you buy one of our brand new MyPillow 2.0s, you get another one absolutely free. And with our overstock sale, you save 50% on our luxurious Giza Dream bed sheets. That's as low as $29.99 for the best sheets ever. And with our biggest closeout special, you get our all-season slippers for only $35. Or our sandals and slides for just $25. Quantities are limited, and once they're gone, they're gone.
Empowering you, the grassroots activist. Here is Dr. Chaps.
Welcome back. I'm Dr. Chaps. Our last story today comes from Judicial Watch. And our friend, former guest of the show, Tom Fitton, reports that the Air Force Academy is now promoting critical race theory, which is another way of saying white people are bad. They're promoting racism in the name of equality, right? Some people are less equal than others. But you will not believe the Marxist drivel being taught at our Air Force Academy, says Tom Fitton. He says he genuinely fears for the future of our military. His organization, Judicial Watch, recently received 478 pages of documents and records from the U.S. Air Force Academy, my alma mater, my beloved academy. It's now a component of the U.S. Department of Defense, which includes instructional materials and emails that address topics such as critical race theory, white privilege, and Black Lives Matter. Judicial Watch obtained these records as a result of a November 22 Freedom of Information Act lawsuit. They filed that against the Department of Defense, who failed to respond after a request for Air Force Academy training materials on CRT. The lawsuit was Judicial Watch versus U.S. Department of Defense, and we won. We got the records released, right? The new records include PowerPoint presentations, for example, one called Political Psychology Lessons 32 and 33, Prejudice and Racism. One of the slides is called Race and Partisanship, and it has the following bullets. They state, quote, Opposition to interracial dating correlated with white partisanship. After Obama's election, despite being unrelated to party identification in previous decades, end quote. In other words, only white people are racist and therefore they are evil and they should be suppressed, thereby reinforcing racism as government policy. Presentation includes another set of tables with the headline, White Americans' Support for Democratic Candidates for President as a Function of Old-Fashioned Racism. So hear that? Unless you vote Democrat, you're a racist. This is being taught to our cadets. Another slide depicts tables which purport to show correlations between Republican Party identification and old-fashioned racism amongst white Americans. This is what they're teaching our cadets. Another slide called Radicalization and Racialization of Public Policy, including a bullet stating, the pollsters found the image of black man greatly impacted responses among Trump supporters. So that's it. If you support Trump, you must be racist. They're teaching this at the Air Force Academy. Now, I'll admit, many racists do support Trump, do hate Obama, right? But just because you're a Trump supporter doesn't mean that you're racist. Just because you're white doesn't mean that you're racist. They're taking the next step of concluding and painting all of us with a broad brush. That's critical race theory at its best. Another bullet in the slideshow says they were less supportive of housing assistance programs. If you don't like paying for welfare handouts, oh, you must be racist. Isn't that implying that only black people get welfare? That's not true. There are many poor white people who get welfare. So it has nothing to do with race if you oppose government handouts that you have to pay for. They also expressed higher levels of anger for people receiving government assistance. They were more likely to say that individuals who receive assistance were to blame for their economic situation. Gave a list of CRT talking points, another document prepared at the direction of Air Force Academy Superintendent Richard Clark. There he is. Worst soup in my recollection of Air Force Academy history. Including the question, does CRT teach cadets to hate our country? The scripted academic answer to the question asserts the following, quote, much of what is divisive about CRT is that it's hard for people to hear the words white supremacy without feeling defensive, even though that is the academically correct way to talk about most of American history, end quote. That's the news. Our thanks to Tom Fitton and Judicial Watch. Listen, when I was at the Air Force Academy, they taught history. I remember in particular my classes on foreign affairs, right? The history of Africa, the history of China, the history of Japan. I mean, these were mind-blowing, you know, world cultural explanations to me as a young cadet of how the world is a diverse place. That's the Air Force Academy that I grew up in. And now they're just teaching anti-America, that America is racist because its founders were white, because its founders read the Bible, because its founders loved Jesus, therefore they must be racist and evil. I can't make that jump. They're making that jump. They're teaching it to young cadets, and I think that is evil. Racism is evil. Jesus hated racism. It's a sin. Whether it's against blacks or whites, let's not go there. The Bible says this in Galatians 3. There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither bond nor free. There is neither male nor female. For ye are all one in Christ Jesus. Let's pray for that kind of unity. Would you pray for me and with me? Father in heaven, we pray for all of our cadets at the Air Force Academy that they will come out of that brainwashing, having resisted it, and having a pure mind that is not racist toward whites or blacks or anybody. Father, we pray that American policy will not be driven by affirmative action or racial politics or stereotypes. Father, we pray that all of this, that our minds will be cleansed by your word and your version of equality. In Jesus' name, amen. Take a short break and I'll have a word to conclude the show.
This is PIJN News, defending your religious freedom. Dr. Chaps will be right back.
How is your marriage doing?
I want to tell you about an exciting new four-part video DVD Bible study series on God's plan for marriage. In this video series, we team up with marriage and family ministry expert Vince Dacchioli.
There are a lot of things that get in the way of our ability to have a healthy marriage. But the way God intended it, He always wanted us to see His view of our relationship together. So everything we do when we talk about marriage, or whether we're talking to men or whether we're talking to pastors and leaders, it all centers around this idea of vision. It's very important that we understand who God is and our relationship with Him is right in order for us to be able to live out really and truly Ephesians.
And that also informs our role as men, how to love our wives. We can't really love them unless we understand the love of God.
Exactly. So if you just think about love, we tend to think that love is an emotion. It's more something that I feel, whereas the true definition of love, the way Jesus intended it, is not just an emotion, but it's charity. It's what I do. You know, to the degree that I am able to see my wife or my spouse through His eyes, that determines everything in my relationship.
Yeah. And we go through the scriptures in four different parts. Part one is God's design for man and woman. Part two is godly roles for husband and wife. Three is sex and intimacy within godly marriage. And also God's plan for divorce. You want to have this important four-part video series available for a suggested donation of $30 if you call our toll-free prayer line at 866-OBEY-GOD. Again, that's 866-OBEY-GOD. Or visit our website, prayinjesusname.org. You too can have a godly marriage.
Defending your religious freedom, here is Dr. Chaps.
Thank you for watching and thank you for supporting us when you visit prayinjesusname.org. This is a viewer-sponsored program. We cannot bring you these shows. In fact, we've had to reduce coverage on some networks because the donations just weren't there. But if you give, we can try to give those back. Visit prayinjesusname.org. The Bible says in Proverbs 21, the fool covets greedily all day long, but the righteous gives and does not spare. Give and give and give. As we give away our wealth, we pray that we will be a hose and not a bucket, right? We're not hoarding anything here. We're giving it away back to the public. Please support us at prayinjesusname.org. If you need prayer, call us at 866-OBEY-GOD. We'll see you next time.
Dr. Chaps needs your financial support to stay on the air. Would you please send your best financial donation today? Please visit prayinjesusname.org to donate online. Or you can mail a check to Pray in Jesus Name Ministries, Post Office Box 77077, Colorado Springs, Colorado 80970. You can also call us toll-free right now, 866-OBEY-GOD. That's 866-OBEY-GOD. Please sign up for our free emails at prayinjesusname.org. Again, that's prayinjesusname.org.